Welcome to the Hour of Harvest. It is great to have you with us as we worship the Lord. Sit back and enjoy as we share the good news of the gospel. We invite you to participate along with us as we sing songs of praise, read the Bible, and pray for those in need. The Hour of Harvest prayer team is standing by to take your prayer requests, praise reports, and lead souls to the Lord. You may call us at 606-464-4250 at any time during this program. May this program be a place where you feel accepted, loved, forgiven, and encouraged in the Lord. Hour of Harvest is touching countless souls with the unconditional love of Christ from the Appalachian Mountains to the Bluegrass region, across the nation, and around the world. From our studios in Beattyville, Kentucky, here is your host of the Hour of Harvest, Margaret Drake.
Good evening and welcome to our service tonight. We have some good singing coming up, and so you will not want to miss it. So get your things done and sit down and enjoy the service. Join with us tonight. And we welcome each of you. We know each day as I read the letters, so many says this is their church. And so we want you to enjoy the service tonight, and you'll enjoy the singing. But we have some good scripture for you right now, talking about the Good Samaritan. You know, we hear the news, we hear so many things happening that are not good. And so let's read what Jesus said about the Good Samaritan. In Luke, the 10th chapter, starting with the 25th verse, "And behold, a certain lawyer stood up and tempted him, saying, Master, what shall I do to inherit eternal life? And he said unto him, What is written in the law? How readest thou? And he answering said, Thou shalt love the Lord thy God with all thy heart, with all thy soul, and with all thy strength, and with all thy mind, and thy neighbor as thyself. And he said unto him, Thou hast answered right. This do, and thou shalt live. And he, willing to justify himself, said unto Jesus, And who is my neighbor? And Jesus answering said, A certain man went down from Jerusalem to Jericho, and fell among thieves, which stripped him of his raiment, and wounded him, and departed, leaving him half dead. And by chance there came down a certain priest that way, and when he saw him, he passed by on the other side. And likewise a Levite, when he was at the place, came and looked at him, and passed by on the other side. But a certain Samaritan, as he journeyed, came where he was, and when he saw him, he had compassion on him. And he went to him and bound up his wounds, pouring in oil and wine, and set him on his own beast, and brought him to the inn, and took care of him. And on the morrow, when he departed, he took out 2 pence and gave them to the host, and said unto him, Take care of him, and whatsoever thou spendest more, when I come again, I will repay thee. Which now of these three thinkest thou was the neighbor unto him that fell among the thieves? And he said, He that showed mercy on him. Then Jesus said unto him, Go and do thou likewise. Be like the Good Samaritan. Help when it is needed, and when someone is in trouble, be a good Samaritan. And so, but you know, kind deeds, kind acts mean so much and go so far in life. And I had something happen to me today that I'd never had in all my life. I had gone to get a shingle shot, and I thought that my insurance would pay for it, but it still had a copay. And there was a couple there that I did not know, and they volunteered, said if I didn't have the money, they would pay for my shot. Well, it put me in shock, because I had never had anything like this happen. And so I thought about this story about the Good Samaritan when they did that. But I was so appreciative that total strangers, I'd never seen them before, but how they were willing to go out of their way, out of their pocket to help me. And I just thank the Lord all day for that, because that kind deed, I hope, will come back to them, because they were so thoughtful in trying to do for someone else. Well, we have a lot of prayer requests in, and we certainly all know what all's happening in the world and in our part of the world, and how much prayer is needed now, like never before. And so, as we go into the service, there'll be people calling. We have a number of requests already in, like all the folk that was involved in that school bus wreck this morning up in McGoffin County, and others, those college boys that were killed and so forth. There's so much to pray about, and that's why I guess it stands out so much when someone is out of the goodness of their heart, wants to do something for someone else just because they care. And you know, we should all be like the Good Samaritan. We should go out of our way to help somebody when we can. Let's pray. Father, in Jesus' name, we thank you for the examples that we have to go by and to live our life. And so, Lord, we do pray that you'll bless each person that is a Good Samaritan, that helps others, and that looks out for them and tries to make life easier for them. And so, Lord, tonight we ask you to bless those people that we met today, and all these people that's so in need, the accidents and killings and murders and everything. Lord, have mercy on our nation, and let it turn back to you in a repenting form, to where that these things can no longer be heard of. Bless our guests tonight and our phone operators, and we thank you, Lord, for your goodness. We thank you that you never leave us nor forsake us, and we thank you for it. In Jesus' name, amen. All right, tonight we have with us a group that you have received really well, and they sing your kind of music, and so we know that there'll be a lot called tonight. We have phone operators up there that'll take your call. We have Buddy and Janice Mullins from over at Mount Vernon, Kentucky. Their phone number is 606-392-3680. And they're ready to sing some of their good songs for us, Buddy and Janice Mullins, right now.
Thank you, Sister Margaret. Good to be here tonight. Good to be on WLJC again. And we just hope you out there in TV land is feeling good, sitting back and ready to listen to the singing, and our prayers that you get a blessing out of it. And we hope we do something or say something to make you feel better. And most of all, do what our Lord and Savior wants us to do. Every time I do a deed I shouldn't do, every time I say a word I shouldn't say, let me tell you what I do, and it brings a blessing too. I just steal away somewhere and pray. I just steal away. I just steal.
and he gives me many blessings every day. So when I have done my best and I fail to pass the test, I just steal away somewhere and pray. I just
send that out to my good friend Jack Hodge. He goes to church with me down at Livingston. I'd like to send it out to my whole church family down at Livingston Pentecostal. And there's so many people that we've run into in the last, well, since we were here before in October, that says, hey, we see you on WLJC, and that really encourages us. But to each and every one that has spoke to us, and it's about seeing us over here, we want to send this next song out for you. Especially to the church family, Livingston Pentecostal. If we don't mention your name, and we told you we would, it's because we forgot it. So forgive us.
Some people steal, they cheat and lie for wealth and what that it will buy. But don't they know on a judgment day their gold and silver will melt away? I'd rather be in a deep dark grave and know that my poor soul was saved than to live in this world in a house of gold and deny my God and lose my soul. What good is gold and silver too if your heart's not good and true? Oh, sinner, hear me when I say, fall down on your knees and pray. I'd rather be in a deep dark grave and know that my poor soul was saved than to live in this world in a house of gold and deny my God and lose my
I'm gonna send this song out here to my buddies up at Bowling Funeral Home.
I'm satisfied with just a cottage below, a little silver and a little gold. But in that city where the rats are, just over the hill.
accident that happened to Jan and I. Went to a nursing home over in Brill, Kentucky this past week and saw a friend of mine over, Lonnie Clark. I've known many, many years. He's over there. And if you know a word of prayer, I would that you would pray for Lonnie. Lonnie, if you're watching tonight, I hope this is a blessing to you. Let's see. Okay, we're staying the same chord. I know. Collins. Okay, we go to A, I guess. All right, this song here has been a staple for me for a long time. You hear it a lot in the bluegrass field. And I like for my Christian life to be just like this old white oak on this hill. I'd like to be firm.
There's a white oak on the hillside near my old Kentucky home that stands straight and true on that windy mount alone. And when the cold winds blow, its roots they bend and moan. And when the storms are past, straightens up and goes on. Lord, when I lose.
send this next song out to my sister, Margaret Miller, and my brother-in-law, A.G.
I'd like to send it out to my two little sisters, Edna Coffee and Don, her husband, and Ralph and Lila Powell. Well, I was standing by her bedside where my fevered mother lay when she called me close beside her and I thought I heard her say,
what a journey it's been. When I was out in sin, I thought I was happy. I used to drink and gamble. I used to be that kind. But since I met the Lord, things are different. Since God gave me a brand new heart, a brand new mind.
A brand new heart, a brand new mind.
Colleen Baker and Uncle Perry Baker. I know they're watching tonight, and we love you all.
Oh, Lord, my God, when I in awesome wonder consider all the world thy hands have made, I see the stars, I hear the rolling thunder, thy power throughout the universe displayed. Then sings my soul, my Savior God, to thee, how great thou art. Oh, how great thou art. Then sings my soul, my Savior God, to thee, how great thou art. Oh, how great thou art. When Christ shall come with a shout of acclamation and take me home, oh, what joy shall fill my heart. Then I shall bow in humble adoration and there proclaim, my God, how great thou art. Then sings my soul, God, to thee, how great thou art. Oh, how great thou art. Then sings my soul, my Savior God, to thee, how great thou art. Oh, how great.
loving that song because Sister Margaret, he is great tonight. There's none no greater.
I think we've sung this song just about every time we've been up here, but it gets better all the time. When I close my eyes in bed, hold my hands up on my chest, and play for me a pretty song while I take. For this courage I have prayed. In his arms I'm not afraid. When I cross that silent sea, the light of home they beckon me. I'll have no fear, I'll feel no harm. So secure in Jesus' arms, not afraid to bid this world goodbye, not afraid. Safest place we can be, wherever. I know. I tell you, I'd rather be in the arms of Jesus anywhere I know of. And what you got, baby?
This next one is Leaving on My Mind. It's a Rusty Goodman song. It's one of my favorites. I love this song. This old house I'm living in is needing repair. The windows shutters are letting in cold, cold air. I say to myself, gonna fix them when I can get the time. But all I'm getting lately is leaving on my mind. Now lately all I've got is leaving on my mind. Oh, it seems that's all I'm thinking about most of the time. Soon and very soon I'll leave my trouble far behind. I've got leaving on my mind. So I guess I should be looking for a better place to live. Oh, but I can't seem to get excited about the world, what it can give. I couldn't care less if I could buy it all. Solitary time. What good would the world do me with leaving on my mind? Now lately all I've got is leaving on my mind. Oh, it seems that that's all I'm thinking about. Most of the time, soon, and very soon, I'll leave my trouble far behind. Lately, I've got leaving on my mind.
We'd like to thank Dennis and Gladys for riding up here with us tonight, good friends. Oh no, we really appreciate them. I'm going to do this, and we don't have it on the list here tonight, but I'm going to do it. I feel like somebody out there tonight won't hear this song. I'm going to do it just for you. I have heard of a land on a faraway strand. There's a beautiful home on the soul, and built by Jesus on the high, where we'll never shall die. There's a land where we'll never grow, never. Church, Livingston Pentecostal, and so many people in the area up earth. We'd like to send it out to Brother Bill Hammonds and his church over Roundstone, and so many different ones. Can't name them all, but it's for you. Praise the Lord. Huh? Okay. Let's see. Oh, there's a land that is fairer than day, and by faith we can see it afar. For the Father waits over the way to
we shall meet on that beautiful shore in the sweet by and by. We shall meet on that beautiful shore. We shall sing on that beautiful shore. The sigh for the blessings of rest in the sweet by and by. We shall meet on that beautiful shore in the sweet by and by. We shall meet on that. We will offer our tribute of praise for the glorious gift of His love and the blessing that hallow our day in the sweet by and by. We shall meet on that in the sweet by and by. We shall meet on that beautiful shore. Yes, we shall meet on that beautiful shore.
All right, we got one more to go here. And okay, this song, we're going to send this out. I forgot to mention, Geneva Spoonamore. She's always great, good about calling in, and she's always asking us to sing for her. So we'll close out with this in here, and we would like to thank Sister Margaret and the station here for having us over. This plane I'm riding, they say it's leaving for a place. Will be my Jesus to my mansion in the sky. Now don't be grieving because I'm leaving, and don't cry when I say goodbye. There'll be no weeping where I'm going.
Go!
don't cry when I say goodbye. There'll be no weeping where I'm going to my mansion in the sky. Yes, to my mansion in the sky.
All right. Thank you so much, Buddy and Janice Mullins from Mount Vernon, Kentucky. And have a phone number that you may reach them and get them come your way to sing. 606-392-3680. That is, unless they're already booked up, and then they'll just have to tell you to come where they are singing. All right, Rick Adkins has called for his mother from Ellick County, but they were complimenting the singers tonight. Gladys from Jackson County, love the singing. She is singing along with them tonight. Helen Wiles, a good friend of ours, enjoying the music, and she and her husband needs prayer. Lou from McGrary County, beautiful singers and loves the old songs. Geneva of England from Mount Vernon, goes to church with the singers and are enjoying them. She watches every night. Okay, Don's family from Clay County is called. Always glad they're always hanging on their papa, grandpa, whatever. Beulah from Laurel County loved the singing and pray for her throat. Charles Willis from Madison County, best blessings from the singers tonight. Veda Lawson from Casey County enjoying the singing. Lee Bingham from Knott County enjoying the singing. You know any of those?
Mm-hmm. Quite a few.
Some of them? Mm-hmm. Okay, well, that's good. That, of course, you never hear from but just a few. You want to, I don't know how much time we can, how many we can get through these, but we'll do as many as we can. Here's Philip Thomas from down in Harlan. He's having stomach problems, is called tonight. Margie from Pulaski, a health issue. Mary from Knott County. Phyllis and Mikey from Laurel County. Some of them are bedfast and a lot of problems there. Tony has got in a lot of pain tonight, wants prayer. Terry from Montgomery County. Mark from Clark County, pray for peace of her nation and her land. Bobby from Berea, pray for Ina. Frida from Mercer County for her husband Lloyd. And Geneva from Johnson County, pray for Ruby, has blood clots and she has had cancer. And she wants us all to have a good Thanksgiving. Thank you. Alfia has called for Dempsey, sons in the hospital. Jeremy for Hannah from Lexington going to visit. Okay, and then the school bus wreck that happened today up in Lagolfin County, I think it was, and we need to pray for all of them. Okay, what do you have there, Janice?
I have Wayne and Kathy Hart, called in by Kathy. I have Eva and family, called in by Eva, Morgan County. And Somerset, pray for William Neely, called in by Willis in Wolf County, pray for Billy Dunn, called in by Tina in Anderson County, pray for her. And Versailles County, Jennifer Brock, anxiety, lost family members. And for family and grandson, called in by mother in Fayette County, many needs in the family. That's all.
We have Brad Frazier, called in by the family in Clay County, has had a heart attack, poor circulation. Thelma Johnson, called in by Thelma Johnson in Madison County. Children, grandchildren, great children, great grandchildren, and great great grandchild. Linda, Jesse, and Cody, called in by Linda in Morgan County. John, called in Perry County. surgery in the morning. Louise from Pulaski County has arthritis. Brooke's husband and three children are very sick. Earl and Goldie, that burger, Montgomery County, health problems. Hattie and Jimmy needs prayer. Laura, May, and Charlie needs prayer. And you know, we're serving the one that can take care of all
that. Can do something about that.
Can do something about it, yes.
So we got a few more here. A woman has called for her nephew's baby girl that was born in Lexington Hospital. Said there's something wrong, the brain is not working, and she's having issues with her kidneys and oxygen, and to pray for the father and mother of this baby, a little baby girl. All right, here's someone wants prayer that his oxygen does not drop, and his friend has thyroid cancer. All right, here's Jeffrey, has strep. Here's someone that gave up her children years ago, and now she's wanting them back, and so that's a very touchy subject. Johnson County, Johnson County, Eva has called. She's had a bad car wreck and a lot of broken bones and so forth. All right, we're going to pray over all these, and we're going to ask Buddy and Janice to anoint them and pray. And you've already called, so we know you've got some faith, and so we're just going to add ours to yours and believe. Go ahead.
Our blessed Heavenly Father, as we come to you, thanking you, Lord, for this opportunity to speak in your behalf. Thanking you, Lord, for your love you bestowed upon us and for your divine healing power that you can reach right down to each one of these. And you know, you don't have to, there's no such thing as you having to run a test. You can just reach down in there and, Lord, and not even leave a scar, no pain, no nothing. You can heal it right then. We know that you can. We know that you will. We love you, Jesus. We ask that you move on each and every one of these according to the way you see fit. We'll not forget to give you the praise in your wonderful name. Amen.
Amen.
Margaret, do I have time to tell a praise report right quick?
Yeah, we've got 3 minutes.
All right, it won't take me long. I went to my family doctor last month, and I had a knot on my left arm, and I was really concerned about that. And when I showed it to her, she was very concerned about it. And I had had melanoma on my right arm 2 years earlier, which I had to have surgery and have it removed. So she was concerned that that had something to do with that possibly, so she sent me for an MRI. And the MRI came back good, and the doctor said, no cancer. That is not cancer. That is a fatty tissue tumor. And if it does not grow within 3 months, we will not touch it. You'll be fine. And I thank God for that.
Yes, I just
have to share that with everybody.
We meant to do that last month.
Yeah.
All right. Well, we appreciate you folk for coming. And are you having time to go to other churches?
We will be now that Betty's retired.
Oh, he's retired?
He has retired from working at the funeral home. We're going to be able to get out and go now.
That's good.
Hopefully we can be available when they need us.
Whenever
they call us, we can go.
We want to do the will of the Lord, and we want to be able to touch somebody, you know.
Yeah.
A lot of years been wasted, you know, but our desire is to do the best we can.
Mm-hmm. All right. So is this the number that to call?
Mm-hmm. That's
you
the wanna, number.
Yep. You want to give it to them?
It's 606-392-3680, and you'll get me.
Okay, that's right to the point. So, all right, and they'll do their best to come talk to sing for you. And we appreciate them being here tonight. And so you be sure and pray for them, and maybe they get so busy they'll have to go back to work to get some rest. That could happen.
Yeah.
All right. Well, looks like our time is come and gone. So from all of us, we want to say good night and God bless you.
Thank you for being a part of the Hour of Harvest. We hope that you are truly blessed and encouraged every time you watch. This program is made possible by your contribution and support. Would you become a financial partner of the Hour of Harvest with a one-time or monthly offering? You can send your pledges of support to the Hour of Harvest, Post Office Box Y, Beattyville, Kentucky, 41311, or visit us online at www.hourofharvest.com. May God bless you.